Freedom Daily News. If you're white, you could soon be paying back reparations for slavery and not know it. We've been hearing a lot lately about reparations for slavery. The idea behind it is that if you're white in America, your family benefits from the work of slaves. It's the guilt trip associated with the sins of our ancestors that we will never be able to pay back. According to those who back this group, the black population in America today has infinitely harder lives because of not having access to funding for college, racism, discrimination, and they wish they'd been left in Africa. For the record, at this point, I think we wish we'd left them too. We're not going to get into discussing all the other countries that have slaves, still, or the fact that many of the slave traders were black themselves. We're not going to address the enormous and ever-growing number of tax dollars coming from white people going to black people and whether that amount would be just paying for all their pain and suffering, because it really is hard to put a price on pain and suffering. What we're going to talk about are the people that are here now, who want your money. The reparations movement is growing by the day, and they're getting more brazen with their demands, and even threats to take what they believe to be theirs. The Conservative Post reported on this issue, and it leaves us with a sense of foreboding. While this young man's opinion and rage is clearly an outlier and not representative of the opinions of the majority of black Americans, it is nonetheless troubling. I cannot help but feel sorry for someone who has been told their whole lives that they will never amount to anything and that they are owed something from an entire race of people who have never done anything to hurt them. What makes America great is that people born into any situation can work hard and become anything they desire to be. Either you believe you can or you believe you cannot, either way you are right. According to Daily Mail, a recently launched reparations website is calling for white people to provide money and services to black people to relieve them of guilt and atonement from slavery. Seattle-based artist Natasha Marin started the website that offers and suggests numerous ways where whites can give back to blacks to relieve their white guilt. Here's an example of what these damaged parties want you to know about the reparations movement. In case you're wondering what they keep saying, it's Uhuru. This is a communist movement in Africa that these kids are obviously a part of. I don't know how it sounds to you, but to me that Uhuru they keep saying sounds a little like Hail Hitler. It also looks a lot like those being videoed have been bullied into reciting a catechism of the black reparations movement. And that's not even addressing the religious comments at the beginning of the video that reek of all-out blaspheme, according to biblical standards. Obviously, I wouldn't normally hold the star of a random YouTube video to biblical standards, but he's the one that brought Jesus into it. Unfortunately, this seemingly confused young man isn't alone. This is a movement that's growing in strength and numbers as white guilt takes hold and those in the black community who consider themselves injured grow in audacity. Via U.S. Herald. In a post, the delusional black activist begins telling white people, if you don't have any descendants, will your property to a black or brown family, preferably one that lives in generational poverty. She continues, white people who can afford to downsize are urged to give up the home you own to a black or brown family. Helm also references Lil Dick white men associated with the alt-right and tells other whites to get they ass fired. Call the police even, they look suspicious. The hilarious list composed by Helm is no doubt a serious attempt by her to somehow bring the issue of slavery back into focus. However, what she's actually achieved by her silly antics is the obvious race hustle. Moreover, Helms is a sad individual using a tragic moment within our nation's history to enrich herself and continue the victimization cycle rather than actually accomplishing something on her own. It's a common thread among left-wing activists, many of whom insist that the only way to properly address historical racism is through reparations. Here's a few of Helm's top 10 list. 1. White people, if you don't have any descendants, will your property to a black or brown family, preferably one that lives in generational poverty. 2. White people, if you're inheriting property you intend to sell upon acceptance, give it to a black or brown family. You're bound to make that money in some other white privileged way. 3. If you are a developer or reality owner of multifamily housing, build a sustainable complex in a black or brown blighted neighborhood and let black and brown people live in it for free. 4. White people, if you can afford to downsize, give up the home you own to a black or brown family, preferably a family from generational poverty. I don't think there's a person in America today that would contend that slavery was a good thing. We were wrong and righted it. It's probably just a little insulting to the families of the hundreds of thousands of white American men who died to free the slaves that their sacrifice wasn't good enough. To date, the United States has done arguably the most to make up for our indiscretion against slaves that any country has ever done. What people conveniently forget is that reparations were paid by slave owners on the day that Union soldiers stepped foot on their property. That ever-taunted 2% of the South that owned massive plantations had their homes and livelihoods burned to the ground. Their families were left in desolation with nothing to show for generations of hard work that was done before slaves were bought and sold en masse to grow cotton and the like. But that's the price you pay for doing something wrong, so their children, for the most part, keep their mouths shut and carry on. We pay our reparations in taxes every day. We pay it in food stamps and subsidized housing and affirmative action. So to those who have any ideas about coming and personally taking any more than that, we would tell them what we told the Mexicans: come and take it, and take it.